Coming up, we'll look at recent advances in how we protect your users across Office apps and Windows 10, starting with Windows Information Protection, which now prevents unauthorized sharing of business data from managed Office apps to personal apps on your PC. And beyond email, I'll show you how you can now protect your users from malicious links in Office apps such as Excel with Safe Links. As you shift to a modern desktop with Windows 10 and Office 365, we are continually investing in our data protection and exploit prevention technologies. For information protection, an important vector that we continue to guard against is inadvertent or accidental data leakage. Office desktop apps are now enlightened with Windows Information Protection, as you can see with the briefcase icon here indicated in the backstage. This means that we can prevent information sharing from managed to unmanaged apps, such as when a user switches between work and personal environments. For example, here I have an Excel file open containing confidential financial information. If I try to copy this information to a personal unmanaged location, such as my personal email, you'll see that I am blocked from doing so. Now, if you're using Intune with mobile application management, this is a familiar scenario. The difference here is that the protection leverages platform capabilities built natively into Windows 10. To get Windows Information Protection to work, your environment needs to support a management solution for Windows 10. Here I'm using Microsoft Intune, and you can get more information on how to enable that via the link below. Beyond Windows Information Protection, as you and your users go about their daily workday, we're also increasing our protection against web-based exploits such as phishing attacks or ransomware. We've had Safe Links, which is a feature of advanced threat protection in Office 365, within email for a while. This protects users from inadvertently navigating to a rogue site after clicking on a malicious link in their inbox. And we are now extending Safe Links protection across popular Office apps such as Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. Here's a common way that an attacker may target Excel. As you can see, something doesn't seem right. The attacker is trying to deceive the user by making it look like the spreadsheet cannot load by rendering all the cells black. In the formula bar, you can see that they are asking the user to click on a cell to retry. Now, if I click on one of those cells, you'll see that it's actually a hyperlink. As you can see here, that the Safe Links routes me to a warning page as to determine that the link is malicious. What I do now is determined by my IT admin. It'll either allow me to override this warning page and continue, or I'll be blocked. Here's how it works. When a user clicks on a hyperlink, the link is checked by the Safe Link service. This checks the URL reputation in real time against a running list of known malicious domains, and as an Office 365 admin, you could also add domains that you wish to additionally block. If the link is safe, the user is taken to the website. If the link is malicious, the user is taken to a warning page as you saw. Unlike using only typical virus and malware signatures, we continuously inform and leverage the Microsoft Intelligent Security Graph for new exploits so that the information is available to all Microsoft services. To activate Safe Links protection for your organization, you need to set up a Safe Links policy. To do this, you need to go to the Security and Compliance Center and navigate to Threat Management and then to the Safe Links section. You either need to create a new policy or add an existing one, like I'm going to do here. As you can see at the bottom, there's a Use Safe Links in Office 2016 on Windows. This enables the Safe Links feature for any Office 365 Pro Plus client that is logged in with a user that is licensed for ATP. And when you hover over the checkbox, you'll notice the clients that are currently supported. Over time, we'll be expanding the Safe Links functionality to other Office endpoints. I hope that you found this brief overview on information and exploit protection updates useful. Coming soon, you'll see us expanding the Office 365 ATP capabilities across all endpoints. This will include mobile and web, as well as other Office 365 experiences. If you have Office 365 Pro Plus and Windows 10, activate Windows Information Protection and Safe Links for your organization today, and visit the links below to learn more. Thanks for watching.